When you insert a new question into your project, ActivePresenter allows you to change its container layout. This feature can be found in the Size and Properties tab, in the Properties pane. Thanks to that, you can arrange answer options automatically or manually. In this video, you will know in detail three container layouts of questions, including None, Grid, and Flex. Let's start with the None layout. It allows you to change the size and position of answer options manually. So, you can drag each answer option to the desired position. Besides, you can also freely resize each of them in the way you want. In contrast to the previous one, the grid layout assigns to the fixed size and position for answer options automatically. That means you cannot change the size and position of each answer option separately. Instead, they will be defined by these properties. Enter a number in this box to set the number of columns in the answer area. For example, if the value is 2, answer options will be automatically arranged in 2 columns. Enter a number in the combo box to set the value of the horizontal space between columns, and this box to set the value of the vertical space between rows. You can change the position or resize the whole group, however, these values will remain unchanged. For further modifications, click the Advanced Settings button. This dialog allows you to define the width ratio between columns and or the height ratio between rows. For example, the 1/2 ratio in the column section means that the width of the first column is 1/2 of the second column. Meanwhile, the 1/3 ratio in the row section means that the height of the first row is 1/3 of the second row. The last type of question layout is Flex. This layout is available for a flex box, a slide, or a group of objects to avoid overlapping with other elements. ActivePresenter offers you several ways to adjust it. The first option is to set the direction, either horizontal or vertical, that you want answer options to be aligned with. Let's try the vertical align first. The next option specifies whether the answer should be wrapped or not. It's helpful when items in the box are too large to display all in one line. The third one shows some commands for aligning items vertically. The first three commands align items to the top, middle, and bottom of the container. The next one is to arrange answer choices evenly, with equal space among rows. As can be seen, there is no space before the first flex item, and after the last one. The last command also aligns answer options evenly with equal space among rows. It also leaves space between rows and the container. If you choose to wrap, you are offered to align columns too. Then, the column will be aligned horizontally from left, center, and right. The next command stretches answer options to fill the maximum size of the column. The last two commands arrange answer choices evenly, with equal space among columns to the container. As for the horizontal alignment, it works the same way as the vertical one, but horizontally from left to right. You are able to align rows vertically when you select Wrap. When you select No Wrap, answer choices are forced into one line. you still can align them horizontally from left to right. The last option determines how the content is displayed if it overflows the container. Select this one, so the overflow isn't clipped and renders outside the container. As can be seen, the answer options are displayed beyond the container, to the edge of the slide. If you select Hidden, it will hide any content that extends beyond the container. Last but not least, if you select Auto, it will show the rest of the content with a scroll bar. However, all items that overflow the left and top position of the Flexbox couldn't be shown. For further information, refer to the video How to Work with Flexbox. That's how to work with the container layouts of questions in ActivePresenter. Thanks for watching.